Alright, we're back. And you're never gonna guess what I chose. Remember Shiny? Remember Shiny did some really cool and interesting games? Okay, where is the picture for it? Okay, it's there.
This is Thaddeus, captain of the Osiris, and I fear this will be our last transmission. We are under heavy pursuit and have sustained critical damage. We are going to attempt an emergency broadcast drop in the Matrix. All we can do is hope that somehow this disc reaches Zion, and if it does, it's not too late.
Whatever's in that box cost Thaddeus his life and the lives of his crew. And I have a feeling if we don't get to it first, it's gonna cost us a whole lot more.
There is only one way to enter the Matrix.
We're in.
On May 15th.
You're here.
The next evolution of interactive entertainment has you.
Let's go.
Enter the virtual world of the Matrix. A parallel universe to the Matrix Reloaded.
Actions that take place in the game that you move through and play affect the film plot.
Packed with 1 hour of exclusive footage.
In the video game, there's certain information that you don't get from the movie.
Written and directed by Larry and Andy Wachowski, the creators of the Matrix trilogy.
It's a very special key, meant only for the
one. Everyone, the Matrix was cool.
Will you bring it to him?
What does it unlock?
The future.
If we fail, Neo fails, and that cannot happen at any cost.
Battle alongside the original motion picture cast.
Niobe, please be careful.
As careful as I can be.
Oh yeah, I need to change the title. Sure.
On a mission that comes down to one question.
So are you red or blue on this?
In the war to save Zion, what part will you play? Go, go, go.
Yeah, I had this when I was younger. It's pretty decent. It's got a bunch of problems. Part of it is the fact that it clearly didn't go through enough bug testing.
What do you think will happen after that?
I don't know.
Probably the worst thing about this whole thing is this. To fully understand the plot of The Matrix Reloaded and The Matrix Revolutions, you had to play this game. Because the movie footage in this game doesn't exist elsewhere. Alright, we're all set up. We can play the game now. The idea was super cool though when it came out. Turn the voice up.
Operator.
Put the subtitles on. It's like in the Matrix trilogy, I don't think Ghost and Sparks, who are main characters in this, actually got any dialogue. I'm going to play this on easy because I am not putting much effort into this. Also, beware movie footage.
Look at him. Like flies to cow pies, crawling over every drop we ever used.
We didn't have a lot of time.
There's also the point of, if you haven't watched the Animatrix, you're not going to understand this opening.
Look, I don't mean to be Mr. Naysay, but do you really think you got a chance in hell of getting at that thing before they find it?
I don't know. But that won't stop her from trying.
Come on, Ghost. It's crazy.
Sparks, how long have you been operating on this ship?
So this was shot alongside The Matrix Reloaded and The Matrix Revolutions.
Or you get the hell out of her way.
You were gonna suggest this. I was looking over my list and it's like, what can we do? It's like, there's Blood Omen 2, but I haven't done Blood Omen or Soul Reaver or Soul Reaver 2 yet. There's Beautiful Joe, but we're doing Devil May Cry 3 at the minute, so let's not do that right now. Super Mario Sunshine? Nah.
We scattered the post office.
It's a drop still.
It's like, you know what? Why not Matrix? Enter the Matrix.
Niobe, this won't be easy.
Thaddeus was my friend.
And we also end up with the question for you guys in the chat. You get to decide whether I play as Will Smith's wife or other person.
And I have a feeling if we don't get to it first, it's going to cost us a whole lot more. So are you red or blue on this?
You know me, Niobe. It's not a choice. It's a way of life.
You want to play as Will Smith's wife? Have you ever played this before, Bane? Have you ever seen this before?
Because I know how valued my opinion is on this ship, I won't bother to tell you. But I think it's insane for you not to wait for a support team. And for the record, when a cartoon.
To be fair, I don't know
prefer cremation or the garden,
anything else that the actually played Ghost has done.
Well, I am what I am, and I do what I can.
And there's minor differences. Niobe will drive in any vehicle sections, whereas Ghost shoots. Execute command. The part in the chateau has a slightly different opening. There's a couple of levels where they go down different paths. I'd say there's enough of a difference that if you had this for yourself, it'd be worth doing two playthroughs. Yeah, Bane, have you played this before? Or seen any of it? You've never seen any of the Matrix movies? What? Alright, playing as Niobe. Yeah, Jada Pinkett Smith, married Will Smith. That's where the Smith comes from.
Why do you do that?
Do what?
Check your guns.
You never know.
It's a program. They get loaded every time the exact same way.
Hume teaches us that no matter how many times you drop a stone and it falls to the floor, you never know what'll happen the next time you drop it. It might fall to the floor.
See, yeah, it's kind of interesting.
Past experience can never prove the future.
So?
So
that this is... It's entirely canon to The Matrix, and events that are skimmed over in the movie are elaborated here. Not in the standard thing of video games like stretching out stuff. No, the movies were filmed with the intention of certain events being explained in this game.
Can I have his boots?
I'd say it's really worth watching The Matrix, at least the first one. Like, the first Matrix movie is just one of those landmark movies in cinema.
Keep in touch.
The game also asks you to save your progress a lot. Really weird places. But yeah, developed by Shiny, who previously developed MDK, if you ever played that. No, After Earth was terrible. We are now closing. This office is open 7 There's also... Is there a strafe? Yeah, you have to hold R for the strafe. And it looks ridiculous. Okay, so the plot events in The Matrix, for anybody who isn't... For anybody who is interested in The Matrix, is in the Animatrix, which is entirely canon and you need to watch to understand everything that's going on in the movies. One of the ships gets some information. And the machines realize they have this information and... make a straight beeline to take them down. And all that this ship is able to do is drop the information off in the Matrix. And now we're trying to find... Yeah, that one part. Now we're trying to find that information.
Ma'am, we're closing.
Because they dropped it in the Matrix.
Sparks, the elevator shut down.
Yeah, I know. Okay, I've got a blueprint online. That's too bad. That elevator would have worked. Okay, hold on. I'm looking for another way.
And this is something... It's a key plot point in The Matrix Reloaded that he's just skimmed over. Like, how they ended up finding this drop point. Not a good place for the camera there. Yeah, basically, that's a pretty solid comparison there, Star. I think a lot of it is the movement, like the way they move. Especially this. So basically, the entire crux of the plot of The Matrix Reloaded depends on us finding this drop that's been made.
The PCS reports?
New cover sheets?
Oh, you got the memo.
Hey, so did they fix the printer?
I hear there's a problem.
Needs more toner.
Could you please leave?
We need help in here!
It's okay to fight civilians because they might turn into agents. I don't think it's that Atari developed this. It was developed by Shiny, published by Atari. But this is Atari. It's not Atari as you think when you say Atari. It's Infogrames, who bought the Atari name and then renamed themselves to Atari and then cranked out a lot of shit. Like Driver 3. If you remember Driver 3 and how much of a disaster that was. But no, they weren't a good publisher. They were very... It was very common for games published by Infogrames under the name of Atari to be rushed. And it's very much a problem with this game. It's got a lot of cool ideas. It could have used a few more months. Because in the end, it's like a... It's, as a game, it's like a 6. Yeah, of course, Drive 3 or Drive 3R, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, that's a game we could possibly take a look at some point. There was a lot of money thrown behind that game. Like, they were really trying to compete with Grand Theft Auto. I like the cast of that game. It's got Michelle Rodriguez in it and Michael Madsen. Oof. Alone in the Dark reboot, Alone in the Dark 5. If you have it on PS3, Alone in the Dark Inferno is probably one of the worst cases. It's a bad game that is so close to being a really good game. And it's one of the saddest things when you play it, because it is so obvious how close it was to being a good game. And you know what the funniest thing about that is? It's not the worst Alone in the Dark game. Hell, he's not getting up. Should have gotten out of the doorway. A lot of just wandering through offices here. No, Alone in the Dark Illumination, I think, is the name. The most recent Alone in the Dark game is the absolute worst game with that Alone in the Dark name. Yeah, I'll lend you, if you're interested, Bane, I'll lend you The Matrix, like the first one. 2 and 3 are personal taste more than anything else. But the first one is one of those movies that you really should watch for its cinematic relevance.
Guard, over here, by this order.
There's a lot of guards here for a post office. Is this common for the US? My unbeatable strategy of just jabbing every now and then. Oh shit, I've got guns.
Oh no.
Don't go up, I think they're expecting you. Cops are everywhere on that second floor. I'm calling your partner for backup.
Oh no. I gotta say though, like, fuck the Wachowskis for making this stuff exclusive to the game. Like, the really important stuff. Because there's a bunch of stuff in this game that is important to the story of Matrix Reloaded. There we go. And I don't think it was released anywhere else. Like, you'd think. It's like, oh, you know, it's been a while. Maybe we'll throw the cutscenes on this. On a Blu-ray. Of the Matrix trilogy. And as far as I'm aware, they just haven't. Which means, with the Matrix Reloaded, you're getting like three quarters of a story. Like, there's the bit in the, on the freeway. Like, the freeway scene is fantastic. The fight that Morpheus is having with the agent on top of the truck is really cool. But then the agent knocks him off the truck, and he lands on the car behind, and it's being driven by Niobe. She's just there. No explanation in the movie. And the game is what explains it, and it's the kind of thing that really should have been explained, and leaves the movie weaker for it.
Really toxic. You gotta stay up high, away from that stuff.
Toxic tear gas? What?
Ghost is getting slowed down, so you're on your own for now.
All right, let's see if we can make this. Yeah, barely. But it counts. Ah, shit. Grab the ledge. God damn it, Niobe. Okay, let's try that again. Also, maybe don't wear high heels when you're probably always expecting a fight. Fast save times, though. That's nice.
Suspect look.
The gunplay in this is absolute garbage. There are actually specific throws for if you have a gun out while you're in combat. Alright, there we go, that's where we're after. I'm kind of curious about how they can justify the fourth movie with how the third movie ended.
Sparks, the P.O. Box area is locked up tight. I don't see any way in.
Yeah, I know.
Like, I don't really want to go into too much detail since Bane hasn't watched any of it, and he probably should.
Find a spot where you can get on.
But like, the third movie leaves no real opening for a fourth movie. Not the way they're doing it.
Just act invisible.
I guess you got a point there, Teek. Boom.
She's by the P.O. box room.
Oh no, I think you should... I think the Matrix as a trilogy is something you'd actually really appreciate, babe. Like I say, I'll lend you the entire trilogy if you're interested, but you should watch at least the first one. For its cinematic relevance. It's one of those movies, like the original Star Wars, or Ghost in the Shell, or Akira.
We can take her down.
Or, like, there's loads of examples. Clash of the Titans. It's one of those movies you should watch just for its relevance to cinema. Well, with the fourth movie still being done by the Wachowskis, I'm hoping for a decent explanation, since it's not just somebody else handling it. Which, you know, is usually one of the problems you end up with, like, stuff like this. They're doing a Fight Club 2? What? And the thing with Fight Club is, like, everything outside of the movie to do with Fight Club kind of missed the point. You should really watch them burn. I've actually got the trilogy set aside as one of the movies that I should rewatch at some point, along with the Star Wars original trilogy and True Lies and Predator. But it's a smoke grenade, and you're both wearing gas masks. Is the second Fight Club movie going to be based on that? Because it's like a lot of people just really missed the point of Fight Club. And a lot of the Fight Club media that came out around the movie missed the point of it. Like, if you ever saw the Fight Club game, that very clearly missed the point of the movie. Different name and a different female character. Fight Club's a decent movie. I think one of its biggest problems is it's been kind of spoiled at this point. It's a spin-off. Alright, let's get out of here. Alright. Like, the Fight Club game, jeez. I think that was another Atari thing. Oh, you know, Infogrames calling themselves Atari. Excuse me, I need your gun. Thank you. Take that. Thank you. See, this is what the lobby scene from the first Matrix looks like if you don't put it in slow motion. Open yet? Yes, it is. Awesome. That's an interesting concept for a sequel. Well, yeah, I think the whole thing with the people hooked into the Matrix being expendable on both sides is, as far as the machines are concerned, there's always more. As far as the people who are disconnected from it are concerned,
Ghost created a distraction for you.
A distraction.
It's kind of a necessary evil because some people just can't be unplugged anyway.
Have I got an exit?
Hold on, I'm looking at your options. Okay. Not gonna like it.
Hit me.
Find the manager's office. It's near where you jumped onto the conveyor belt.
On the second floor?
That's the you're not gonna like it part. Just call me when you get there.
Okay. Basically, there's also the concern that, say you leave somebody alive, at any point, anybody who's still hooked up to the Matrix could turn into an agent, and that's a bigger problem.
I can't see anything.
Ah! Ah! monitor. Excuse me. Kill him. Thank you. Almost out of MP5. Okay, I definitely didn't blow this place up, though. Unplugged brings up the problem of the one character in the first movie. Some people will just prefer the Matrix because people are people. They kept people alive in a world that wasn't going to change, it wasn't going to get worse. You'd think with how important this is that there'd be agents around here, but there isn't. Human mind would not accept paradise. Excuse me. Thank you. Now, a lot of people dislike the Matrix Reloaded and Matrix Revolutions, but I think they have a lot of good ideas and expanded on the original concept.
Listen, I've got it. Just working on the timing. You gotta put your back to the city map. It's across the room from the big window. Good. Hang on. I'll be with you in just a sec. Here we go. Now, when I say go, I want you to run for that big window in front of you and jump through it. Trust me, this is gonna be fine, I think.
Ready?
Go!
The rave scene in the, the reload marines everywhere. Zion! Hear me! It is true what many of you have heard. You know, I don't have too much of a problem with that because a lot of the action scenes in Reloaded are fantastic. But yeah, I'll agree with the pacing. I think the big problem is the Matrix, the first Matrix movie has a very specific... There we go. It's a pretty basic plotline with some interesting elements focused around it. But as the character grows, it's... Like, this might sound kind of bullshit, but... The Wanted movie basically goes through the same plot. Not anywhere near as good, but... As far as the main character's growth goes, once the Wanted movie does the same thing. Because it's a very basic plot that you can do, and then you just build a world around that.
They're right behind you.
Yeah, I like a lot of the philosophical ideas that Reloaded puts out. It's kind of an interesting idea. And I'm not entirely sure what it is about Hugo Weaving, but he can talk bullshit all day and I'll just be there listening with rapt attention. Probably why they cast him as V in V for Vendetta. He can be saying nothing. Like, entire paragraphs of nothing, and he makes it sound so engaging.
Surrender.
It's like the, this is in-game music, yeah. It's like the bit, the last little band he has at Neo in The Matrix Revolutions. And there was a point where I had most of that memorized. Why do you do it, Mr. Answer? Why persist? Could have believed it because you're fighting for something, something more than yourself? Could it be for peace? Justice? Could it be for love? Illusions, Mr. Anderson. Vagaries of perception. Senseless constructs. And I've lost the rest of it. Delusions, there you go. It's like Hugo Weaving sells the entire role, it's great. So one of the differences you get if you choose Ghost instead of Niobe is Niobe drives and Ghost shoots. So if you play as Ghost, you do the shooting. Yeah, he did greatness. Why won't you die? Because beneath this mask is beneath this mask is more than that. Beneath this mask is an idea. Ideas. What do you do? But as an adaptation, V for Vendetta is kind of weak. As its own movie, I really like it. And it's probably entirely because of Hugo Weaving. Okay, now we can go. Hold on. Yeah, all of that was in-game music. I'm not playing anything outside the game. I think it's one of the things, like, why it was kind of disappointing that Hugo Weaving was cast as Megatron in the Transformers movies. Because they don't really give him anything to do with it. I think we just killed Ghost.
Close. The fire escape. On your left.
Hurry. There's a maintenance phone on the roof.
The phone is behind the roof access door.
Thanks, Sparks. I couldn't have been on the ground floor.
Oh. Oh.
Go. Find the door. I got your back.
Cinematography in this isn't that bad. Not the kind of thing you'd usually see in a game of this era. Let's get out of here before that agent shows up. There we go. Alright, we're almost at the exit. It's just through this door.
It's here! I found the exit!
Ah, shit. That character model looks terrible. Okay, you know what? Let's read the tip for agents. Because like we've got all these tips, which basically serve as tutorials to pop up as needed. Run. It's like, we ain't Neo. Shit, I took a wrong turn. Like, we're not Neo. We can't take on agents. Gotta get out, gotta get out. This whole thing of how agents can just be everywhere. Like, the way the game captures it. And, like, this is very much a case of nostalgia whoring and trying to recreate a scene from the movie in the game. It's trying to redo the scene that the first Matrix movie opens with Trinity running from the agent. And it's pretty effective. Hey, not that way. Excuse me, gents. Not dealing with you. That ladder climb looks stupid as hell. There's the exit. The biggest question for me with that kind of thing is, how big is the world in the Matrix? And now we're back to the movies.
You okay?
I think that is like the only time the game really does it.
Tell me about it.
To be fair, too.
Shaun, Dr. Feelgood can fix you up.
Right now, all I want to know is what's on that disc.
Sir, we just received an emergency broadcast from the Logos.
She did it.
Yes, sir. The last transmission of the Osiris.
This is Thaddeus, captain of the Osiris. It is 1803...
We're not going to linger on this shot because it's pretty clear that this isn't actually a real person because this was done in CG. The Animatrix.
We tried to outrun them on the surface when our sensors went completely berserk. We didn't believe what our equipment was telling us.
Yeah, my question mostly has been, how big is the Matrix? Is it one big city? How much is beyond that city?
Times the size of anything we fought. We are under heavy pursuit and have sustained critical damage. We are going to attempt an emergency broadcast drop in the Matrix. After that, all we can do is hope that somehow this disc reaches Zion, and if it does, it is not too late.
Drop down in Zion broadcast. I want this data transmitted immediately. Emergency encryption.
Lieutenant.
Yes, sir.
Is the logo still in contact?
Yes, sir.
Get me Captain Niobe.
Live feed from Zion.
That's a good question.
It's Deadbolt himself.
Is it all one thing? Is it different servers? Do we log into different servers?
Captain, you and your crew to be commended. What you have done may prove to be the turning point in this.
If it is servers, are the servers in which there are no red pills?
Return to Zion. Full protocol as fast as humanly possible. I leave the recall in your hands, Captain.
Yes, sir, Commander.
Captain. Niobe, please be careful.
As careful as I can be.
I think you're right there, Professor. How long has people?
Has that ever happened? Won't be easy making that many out calls.
That's why we're going to use the airport. All those different payphones will make a trace impossible. We can split up and stay mobile.
What could go wrong?
Right.
I think the biggest question isn't necessarily how long have people been connected. It's how are people born? Like, Morpheus has the whole line of people are no longer born, they're grown.
You have reached the Daniel Institute of Dream Interpretation. Please record your message.
That's Lawrence Fishburne.
I am calling to confirm that your order of red orchids will be delivered tomorrow.
But it's like, how do they birth people?
This is the great beyond.
Is there a genetic line?
We will get back to you as soon as humanly possible.
I am calling to confirm that your order of red orchids will be delivered tomorrow by midnight.
Operator.
Jax.
Niobe, is that you?
I'm not sure I can talk right now, Jax.
Niobe, listen to me. They got Axel. Soren led everybody in after him. It's bad, Niobe, real bad.
Where?
The airport.
What? We're at the airport.
Please, you gotta help us. Agents have cornered Soren. They're moving Axel to the tarmac. If they get him in the air, I'll have to pull the plug.
What the hell happened down here? Thought you said we just...
It's just a bunch of questions.
It's Soren. Agents pinched one of his crew. Now they've come in to try to rescue him.
Here.
Yeah. Lucky for him, not so lucky for us.
So this is a point, actually. Soren is a very minor character in The Matrix Reloaded and Revolutions. No, he's not in Revolutions, is he? He's just Reloaded. This whole sequence explains why one of the characters doesn't go into The Matrix at a specific point. Special virtual hug. I've heard of virtual hugs. Isn't that what Second Life is all about?
This airport is performing an emergency evacuation. Please remain calm. All non-security personnel, please make your way to the nearest marked exit in an orderly manner.
There are the escalators. So what you're saying is, the machines create more people through the power of wet dreams?
This airport is performing an emergency evacuation.
Out with the ID.
Shit, it's her.
Right. Wow, TSA has gotten really violent. A woman tries to walk past him, he just punches her in the stomach. Thank you. Alright, that's where I want to go. So this is another point where you'll do a different thing if you're playing as Ghost rather than Niobe. Well, that's the thing, isn't it? Chances are all of the waste that they extract goes somewhere.
Niobe, I've got movement bunching outside. I'm also monitoring an agent, so keep your head down.
I just caught a transmission. Get over to the hangar by the remote terminal. That's where they're taking Axel.
She is an actual terrorist.
Don't get to that hangar now.
That guy didn't know.
How do I get to the hangar from here?
Easy. Get on belt number 10.
Will do.
Alright, number 10. Oh, they've shut them all down. Alright, let's get going. You know, at some point, it's probably going to be worth doing Path of Neo. That'll probably be a fun game to do for stream.
Please, don't shoot me.
There we go, turn back on. Belt number 10. Get out of here. The thing with Path of Neo, though, is if you haven't played, if you haven't seen the Matrix movies, you're not going to understand the plot through Path of Neo, because Path of Neo's plot is explained through... Path of Neo's plot isn't explained. You have to know the movies. God damn it. Because, like, it has a bunch of scenes taken from the movies in really weird orders and stuff. And they're very abstract and doesn't really make sense. And then it'll have one scene that is relevant to the next level. You know the old saying, one man's freedom fighter is another man's terrorist. Being able to bend the rules means we can shoot bullets sideways out of our gun. Chemistry. me. Okay, so belt 10 is over that way. Okay. That's 11. 10's gonna be next to it. Niobe, geez, climb the damn thing. I was watching Mobile Seed Gundam Wing, and just kind of stopped, and like that's my experience with Gundam. But I like mecha animes. And I've just never really gone in with Gundam. I think part of it is like trying to figure out where to start. I'm sorry, what? I just died. There was no build-up or anything, I just died. Closer, and boom. Seven R. I think, like, the problem with getting into something like Gundam is it's been going for so long and there's so many series and alternate universe versions, and it's like, where do you start as a newcomer in this day and age? Yeah, what is this one? F. Alright, I'll just keep going then. I think at this point it's less pressed for time, more... can this series hold my attention? From Lara until we reach 7. Alright. A separate level. Oh no, not an agent.
Tunnel 7R confirmed. Follow the signs.
Sparks gotta go.
So, original is Mobile Suit Gundam Seed, right? Okay, so you run faster with focus. Wall running. Fun fact, it will never actually be practical. Yeah, watch it. Almost out of focus. Not good. Not good. Four. Five. I think this is it. Alright, let me take a look at what it is that I've got, because I do still have it on my computer. Mobile Suit Gundam Wing. I don't know where I'm getting Seed from. Like, that's the one that I was watching. And how far did I get? Episode 10. I've not watched episode 10 yet. I didn't have Toonami as a kid, so I don't know if Toonami was really different for us in the UK. We did have Toonami. I don't know if it was different from us than it was for you. Barhanger. But like, I didn't really have the channel anyway. Wing and Seed are alternate universe. Are you talking about 00? Oh, what do you call that? 100, I don't know. Doesn't go as planned. Nothing ever does it? Yourself up against the wall. Okay, I'm gonna go right there if you're not gonna give me a direction. You know, you say it gets weird in the second season, that kinda reminds me of the Big O, if you ever watched that. And the first season is great, the second season is weird and goes in a very different direction. Yep. God damn it, Niobe. Can I even get back up? Nah. I don't like the Big O. Oh, okay, we succeeded with something, I guess. I thought we were supposed to get on the plane wings. Those fire effects are terrible. Well, we failed. That's nice. I don't know where we are now.
Ghost, where are you?
I'm in the control tower. Are you okay?
I'm not dead. Axel might not be so lucky. I need your help. There's a Gulfstream, taxiway F-12. Axel is on board.
I see it.
Can you stop it?
I might be able to shoot out the tires. Range is extreme.
Thanks. I'm heading there now.
Sparks, here we go.
I need to get in front of that plane.
If Ghost can slow it down, Tunnel 5R should put you on an intercept course.
And we're off. Oh, it's really dark in here. Like, it's coming through brighter on the stream than it is for me on my TV. I can barely see anything. Let's see, on the TV. Stairs. There we go. Awesome, we're there. I also have Outlaw Star that I was watching and just kind of stopped. Why was there a SWAT guy in one of those? I can't entirely sure what we accomplished there. How did we just get inside? I feel like there are steps that we're missing here. Thank you. It's this away. Oh, it's this way now. I love the way that the way the standard jump works. If you press it in the right rhythm, your character will alternate the stride that they jump with. Like this. Oh, he's not doing it properly. No. But if you do it in the right rhythm, you can make it look like your character is doing some really weird skipping. There we go, jeez. Alright. Gotta get that plane. So, they've caught a red pill and they're trying to keep him alive to interrogate. Which means there's got to be an agent on board that plane. Like, there's no way you wouldn't have an agent guarding it. Surely. Yeah, there he is. Hello. If you kept the cargo door shut, you wouldn't actually have a problem there. Oh, that looks hokey as hell. No, don't put the brakes on. Accelerate, accelerate. Sure hope that pilot doesn't turn. It's going to turn into an agent, isn't it? Agent on board. Something, something. Some parachutes. Where are the parachutes? It's pointing me here. Oh, there they are. Okay. Alright, let's go. Back to Axel before an agent inevitably turns up.
Hey, Obi?
Yes, it's me. You're gonna be alright. Let's get out of here. Damn. You can't walk.
Maybe. Stand.
You've got to focus. We don't have much time. Trust me. You'll feel much better when you wake up.
Oh, there it is. You know what? Not a bad visual effect for a video game in, like, 2002.
You won't be needing that.
That agent voice is kind of a little too passive, though. Well, that's not helpful. Hey off, World Devil. Welcome to the stream, buddy. Where'd he go? Where did he go? You okay there? We've got a parachute, why don't we just jump out of the back? Yeah, this game definitely could have done with a little more testing. Since he seems so focused. Oh no, there we go, we fixed it. The movement in combat is so hokey. I believe they did, although given the way Atari was releasing games at the time, it may have also been that. Damn it, I need it in a different direction. Come on, come on. Get out. Get off my plane! Yeah. I think I fixed it. Ah, did you see the agent just running with the wall? Right, off-world devil. Was kind of simple for an agent.
I guess you were due for some luck.
Did you get Soren out?
Yeah, and call the rest.
I guess.
Good.
What was going on with Axel in the back there? I guess the machines were hadn't finished beta testing that agent.
All right, Axel. That's your dust off.
You know, there's a lot of guys who wouldn't have done what you did. I think
base agent.
You would have.
It was that or kill you.
I'm just glad fate brought you to the airport.
I'm not sure you'll agree with that tomorrow. Just tell Soren midnight. He'll know the place.
Fast.
Yeah, I was saying earlier, like, this game has a whole thing of cutscenes, scenes filmed on sets, directly filmed during the filming of The Matrix, Reloaded and Revolutions.
72 hours.
What did you just say?
That's exactly how long Zion lasted last time.
What do you mean, and who are you?
It's like, these were filmed with the sets, with the actors, with the direction of the Wachowskis, as they were doing the last two movies, and it's really disappointing because the game has important scenes for the plot of the second movie, especially the second movie. And these scenes don't exist in any of the releases of the movie. But you need these scenes to get the complete experience. And they should have just reworked a bunch of this back into some of the later re-releases of the movie. No, I don't think it's Hugh Laurie.
You're here.
The game is jank. Really is.
Ghosts?
They're waiting.
Has everyone arrived?
All but the Nebuchadnezzar.
Figures. Anything for an entrance.
Because when we see this area in The Matrix Reloaded, it's when Morpheus arrives with his crew. We don't see them assembling.
Captains.
Captain Niobe, my crew and I appreciate what you did for us back there.
How is he?
He's alive. Happy to be alive.
Let's get going, because you know Morpheus is not going to show until after we get started.
I agree. I don't like us all being in the same place for too long. Why don't you tell us what this is all about, Niobe?
The machines are digging.
You think it becomes obvious who's a red pill to anybody who knows to look for them? Because the red pills always dress so fancy when they're in the Matrix. You know, I'm not sure which character we're actually talking about here.
Shit, no.
It's the feds.
Get to your exits.
I think that's the only time the agents were ever referred to as feds in the series. Oh yeah, no, I know what you're talking about now. Yeah, he played two different characters in Mad Max 2 and in Beyond Thunderdome. And it's really weird because you expect him to be the same character in Beyond Thunderdome, and he's not. In a sewer. I'm probably gonna fall into a bottomless pit here. I can feel it. Yeah, he's supposed to be a different actor. No, he's supposed to be a different character in the in Beyond Thunderdome, which is weird because he's basically the same character. Is it? Let me turn it down a bit. I think part of the problem is the game gets just really loud sometimes. Stopping a fall to your death. Where is it? Walk off a ledge. Move quickly. Move towards the ledge. Okay. Like right now, everything is pretty quiet in the game, but then it'll do the really loud music. Fun fact, this game was two discs on GameCube. But it wasn't on PS2 or Xbox. Because, you know, the GameCube had those mini DVDs that had way less space on them. There is. It's actually not available outside of the main menu because fuck Atari. But The only thing we touched when we were setting up was the voice volume. Because everything's set at like 50%, and we turned the voice volume up to max and didn't touch anything else. You know, I don't miss this kind of thing from games of this time period. The really shitty checkpointing. It's like, okay, great, because of Ballard dying when I couldn't seem to do anything about it, we now have to do this long, boring walk-up section again. You know, I'm not entirely sure what Ballard does for the rest of the series. Yeah, at least it's skippable. Like, that'd be like the worst sin if they weren't. But would this be in a game that has very heavy control and... Like, the Wachowskis would have had to have a lot of say in how this game worked and how it went. And with them being movie directors, I could have... believe that they would have said no. Don't let them skip the cutscenes. We put a lot of work into the production of this. Don't let them skip the cutscenes. I could believe that from movie directors.
Ballard.
But thankfully, that's not the case. Yeah, I'm not aiming in first person.
Okay, step it up.
I'm coming.
Chosen one. I'm coming. Chosen one. I'm coming. You know, that's fast loading, though. I'm getting flashbacks to doing this when I was way younger, and I think the trigger... It's not that Ballard will die if you leave him. I think he'll die automatically if you walk past a certain point. I might be wrong, but I feel like that's what it is. Which is stupid. The wall run. One of those things that feels so quintessentially Matrix, and of course was one of the major parts of advertising for this game, and there is never actually a reasonable point to do it. But the best is when you see them climbing down the ladder, though. Well, that's not very good. Amazing. Super fast ladder climb. Super fast ladder climb.
Ballard.
Alright. I got my gun. Help Ballard by dispatching his assailants. There's two guys. Ballard is supposed to be a captain of a ship. And if Ballard can't take down two SWAT guys, why is he the captain of a ship? Like, seriously. The most exciting bullet time. Can I? No, they're shooting him with a freaking sniper rifle that kills him in like two shots. Ugh. This is going to be the rest of the stream, I can feel it. Like I said, there is basically never a good time to do the wall run. One of those things that was advertised pretty heavily, but like the split jump in Splinter Cell. I remember when Splinter Cell was first coming out. And welcome back, Clem. I remember when the split jump was so heavily shown in the pre-release stuff for Splinter Cell, and then there's maybe 2 points in the game where you can actually use it. Like the jetpack in Crash Bandicoot 2. You should probably stop believing, Clem, because this is like the fifth time we've been trying to do this. Turns out being a red pill will not save you from sniper rifle ammo. From being shot with a sniper rifle.
Valor.
Thank you.
Albie, well done. Okay, step it up.
I'm coming.
Thanks, Clem. Okay, so I have to take out whoever's sniping Ballard before they kill him, but they get two shots off and that's it. There it is. There. Oh, did Ballard actually take that one out? Oh, for fuck's sake. There's three guys? Tell ya, rest of the stream. You know what's one of the weirdest things about this game is the hacking minigame you can do from the main menu, which is weirdly in-depth. Like, there's so many pieces to the whole thing, and you can unlock a bunch of stuff with it. It's kind of really crazy. You know what? The animation for that wasn't too bad considering we're on a slope. I was expecting this to be worse. I was expecting us to possibly clip through the slope, but we didn't seem to. One day we'll make it through this. What a thrill.
Valor.
Shut him down! They're setting up a crossfire. Albie, well done. Okay, step it up.
I'm coming.
Okay. Try this. So we know there's at least three people sniping Ballard.
I'll head them off.
More? Did we do it? I'm not hearing any more gunfire. Did we do it? Yeah, thanks for waiting, dick. Okay, we finally made it. That was probably your belief, Clem. We just kept screwing up until you believed us. Posted guard watching all the maintenance phones down here. Phillips, right here, sir. Take 4 of your squad and stake out this phone. If anyone approaches, shoot to kill. Yes, sir. These guys actually know what the phones can do. Yes, sir. Oh, there you are. Okay, somebody's hitting me now. But not anymore. Takes multiple bullets, it seems. Okay, where is this? Where are the shots actually coming from? There you are. Now we can do the phone. Nope. Up there. Right, okay, up there. Okay, the phone's ringing, let's go. Well, we've got the European box out there, and that's rated 15. Ghost is in the heat of it. He's holding back some troops to buy time. Possibly because of time constraints, I don't know. Jacob from the Gnosis is injured and unconscious. Corrupt is protecting him right now, but they're pinned down in the hydro pump room at the end of the concourse. I told them to open the vent. I'll watch over you, Captain. It's a good question. Like, the only blood we've seen so far was... when the agent bashes the door open into our face. Thanks for joining us, Bane. Take care, buddy. I'll catch you next time. Okay, there's gotta be a switch for this. Unless... How do I throw grenades? I don't think it's told me. It's gotta be the grenade. Yeah, thank you. I get it. I don't know how to throw grenades. Not that there's many buttons on the GameCube controller. Hold A for secondary fire. Yeah, that's it. Ah, shit. That is one of the biggest explosions I've ever seen of, from a grenade in a video game. Right, that was crazy. Nice. Didn't kill either of them. How disappointing. You know, I just realized it's actually been a while since we did some hand-to-hand. Like, the grenade thing is... It's not an issue with the game, it's an issue with the GameCube. And its lack of buttons compared to the other systems. But the GameCube ends up with, I think, three less buttons. Because it's missing a shoulder button, and then it also, the analog sticks don't click in. So you don't have those buttons either. This game is weird in that your health will regenerate really quickly a lot of the time, and so dying doesn't feel like much of a worry a lot of the time. But then there are times where it'll just immediately kill you with no warning. Yeah, let me pull out the shotgun, that'll just make it easier. Nice. Wasn't even pointing at that dude. Off. Do the super jump. Yeah. Back up. There we go. Okay, can't go that way. You know, that makes me think, actually, the whole die you bitch just popped up. There wasn't much swearing in Matrix, was there? You know, that's a game I've got set aside to play through at some point. The X-Men Origins Wolverine. Because the healing factor in that game was pretty neat.
Sector 2, clear!
Because, like, that game... somehow... they decided to, you know what, let's make this into a... Where is it? It's there on my shelf. Is it an 18 or a 15? It's an 18. They made a game based on a PG-13 movie into an 18 movie. I don't remember what it is you're talking about, Clint. Like, they made the game and somehow were allowed to make the game into an 18 rather than just a game to go with it. You know, I could believe that Cypher swears. That's not what I wanted. Get off the wall. Ah, yeah, tank. Believe it or not, you piece of shit, you're still gonna burn. Yeah, no, you're right. Thanks for reminding me, Clem. Climb it. Yeah, the X-Men Origins Wolverine game, for some reason, somehow, they managed to get the permission to make it into an 18-rated game, and they go all out with it. And they really do good stuff with the healing factor. Like, your skin peels away, and you can see muscle and eventually bone underneath, and then it'll heal in real time, and it's really cool. I should play that game at some point. For the stream. Yeah, if you've never played it, it's on PS3 and 360. It's referred to as the Uncaged Edition, which is specifically the HD version, because it was on PS2 and Wii, and I think PSP as well, and those games were a lot tamer, as well as just being different games entirely.
Obi, that was the last one.
But, no, the PS3 360 version, worth a look, it's a fairly solid hack and slash, a little repetitive, but it's definitely way better than the movie. Okay, how do I get up though? They also do a bunch of stuff with it and okay. Like, really expand on it. Like, you'll fight Sentinels at one point, which of course didn't appear in the movie. There's a bunch more connections to the comics, which you usually see with the video games that are tied into the movies. Like how the Spider-Man games tied into the movies. Like, Spider-Man 2 has Shocker and Mysterio and Black Cat, and none of them are in the movie, that kind of thing. I think I might have figured this out. No, I don't think I have. Okay, the arrow just pointing down isn't helpful. That also isn't helpful. That is also not helpful. Right, you just have to go to the other side. That looked really stupid. All this. But it's a pretty neat game. You can definitely do worse for superhero games. And worse for movie tying games. Yeah, I'm glad that worked out. Because at the base of the gear. Oh, you mean this? Can I aim in first person? Yes. Okay. There we go. Alright, I guess we're out of here. Is it just me or does it feel like we're just kind of bouncing between places with no real coherence?
I'm still alive. Who else can I keep that way?
Malachi and Bane from the Caduceus. Follow the spiral staircase down.
Fun fact, Bane will later on be the person that Smith possesses. I heard that entire plotline of Smith possessing Bane came about entirely because the actor who played Bane could do a great Hugo Weaving impression. That's kind of neat. Kind of like how the that scene in Die Hard where John McClane and Hans Gruber actually meet was added in pretty late in production after they found out that Alan Rickman can do a decent American accent. Like you watch the movie and you know you got to give the guy credit. He does a great Hugo Weaving impression. You can really believe that Smith has possessed Bane. It's like the thing everybody, whenever anybody does impressions, the thing they always try to do with the impressions is mimic the voice. When the real key to a good impression is the speech patterns. It's like, I think it's Kevin Pollak does a really good Christopher Walken impression. You can find a lot of other people who can do a better, do the voice better. But, I forgot what his fucking name was now. I'm pretty sure this is what I'm after. I said it a minute ago and I can't remember what the name was. But the dude, like, you'll find people who do better impressions of the voice, but he does the speech patterns perfectly. Why can't I pick up the friggin' thing? My inventory isn't full. Yeah, it's gotta be the flashlight that I need. Why can't I pick it up? Alright. Oh, is that it? It was just down here? This game is really bad at checkpointing stuff. Like pointing out exactly where you need to go with this. Like the goal tracker is really unreliable. Let me get on the ladder first, you dick. It's too dark to go on, you need that flashlight, but then the flashlight is actual garbage.
It's at the end of the canal, just ahead.
Okay, so at this point, after having to protect Axel and Ballard and Corrupt and Ice, now it's going to tell me about ally health. Tech character. That's basically what it is. Oh no, now he's dead. For some reason. We're gonna have this level from the fucking start, aren't we? Yep. Let me just back my character up like I'm driving a freaking car. Yeah, my guess is I didn't get to where I needed to be fast enough. But it's also worth noting that that's a guess. Like, God knows why the game decided the character was now dead. Okay, it's too dark. Need the flashlight. The flashlight is down here for some reason. Clear objectives. I think it's one of, like, we mentioned before, like, the game needed definitely several more months. But, I hate several things. Bug testing, more play testing for shit like this.
To the end of the canal, just ahead.
Definitely. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure about that. It'd be worth looking into. But, like, this game sits in a pretty unique position in that it could have gone alongside the movie release, or it could have come out 6 months later and still been relevant because The Matrix Revolutions was due out soon. And this game could have been used as a stopgap between the two. This guy is absolute fucking garbage. Could have released by Revolutions, could have released partway between the two, bridge the gap. It's like, I think, as long as it's not releasing alongside the DVD, it's like releasing alongside the theatrical release is or was pretty normal. Releasing alongside the DVD release was usually considered to be a really bad sign. And the Blade 2 game did that. And the Blade 2 game is crap. The Superman Returns game also did that. And while it's kind of interesting and has what is still one of the largest open worlds in a video game, and I think was the last time it was a dedicated Superman game. Superman Returns the game is also crap. These grenades are so unreliable. Like, there's no proper way of aiming them. And then they'll just go anywhere. That guy fell off. Okay, so my guess for the minute I don't know why the gold trap is still pointing down there. Because I got the flashlight. My guess for the minute is that when the gold tracker turns around and points me in the other direction, that I need to ignore it and stay where I was. I mean, the gold tracker's clearly glitched now, so... I love the M16. Okay, so there's the dude. I need a hand. Is that it? Is that what we needed to do? Is that what the problem was? Gold tracker pointed in the other direction too quickly. Alright, let's try going to the other end now. Yeah, this was a cool game when it came out. I played a bunch of it. I went through it multiple times with both characters. That's why I know specific things like if you choose Ghost, the airport, the entire airport sequence is completely different because you go in a different direction than Niobe does. Dude over there. It's more difference than you would have expected from a game like this. And it's more difference than you'd expect based on the first level. Because the post office is the same for both characters. Doesn't matter which character you pick. But then a bunch of stuff after that does get pretty different. Most of the chateau sequence is pretty different depending on the character you play as. I think Niobe has an extra boss that Ghost doesn't fight. I say I've done both, but the main thing with this—that's not a bad sequence. The main thing with this was I just let the chat pick which character I play as. Okay, so the trick there, it seems, was to ignore the goal tracker. There's a lot of detail put into these levels. And Shiny were pretty good at making games. Well, if you ever played MDK, MDK is a weird game. But it's pretty neat and probably worth doing a stream on it sometime. And I say one stream because it's pretty short. You can get the game done in one session. Maybe a little over 3 hours. But Shiny was made up of... Yeah, that seems like a glitch. I think they were called Virgin Games previously. Or people who were in Virgin Games and then they left and formed Shiny. I'm not sure. But it's basically the dudes who made Earthworm Jim. Is it this way? Is the objective, is the goal tracker still pointing in the wrong direction? It's like, I've never really played Earthworm Jim, and it's never been a game that I've been interested in based on the way it looks. It looks like the kind of platformer that I'm not really into. But I know a lot of people are into Earthworm Jim. And, like, it could be worth checking out some of the other stuff they did. Yeah, it's garbage. And the stupidest thing was the game would not let me progress without it. It was like, you need the flashlight, it's too dark up ahead. And then we got the flashlight and it did basically nothing. No. Jeez, don't just do that when there's dudes there. Okay, this is probably going to be a bad idea. Oof. You know what though? I'll definitely give to the game. It has fairly decent ledge grabbing protection. Like, that's not bad. That is janky as fuck. Look at that. I'm wondering, like, whether or not they mocapped any of this, and if that's just how Jada Pinkett Smith will go hand over hand. It's like, you feel like this would be the kind of game where they'd mocap everything. Especially since, like, it's a big tie-in with The Matrix, which... Like, yeah, a lot of people are down on the sequels these days, but when the sequels were coming out... Nah, it never does. I don't know what that noise was. I'd like to remind the audience, we've been in the sewer level for like 45 minutes at least. Remember, developers, nobody enjoys the sewer level. God damn it. We've been in here for a while, Ninja. Like, it's a sewer sequence that just keeps going. The main thing you missed was the game lying to us about what direction to go in, which kept getting us a game over. Every time I try and use a grenade, it's just so worthless. Like, look at the throwing arc. I will try and throw one down there, because we're targeting those guys. That is probably the most useful a grenade has been so far. Let's try and recreate that. Wow, we managed to actually recreate it. Offensive slur grenade. You throw it out and it just... See, there you go, that's the typical fare for the grenades. You throw it out and it just says... One of those words you're not allowed to say on TV. Well, it didn't screw up twice, and then it screwed up twice. So it's like, you know, it was making me look like a fool, and then it proved my point. You know, maybe if the freaking level wasn't so dark. You're quoting the wrong movie there, Ninja. Yeah, the orchestra, the music for this has been really weird. Nothing's going on. It's like da 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 mean, not that, but you know. Data Pinkett Smoth. Like, just, like, you know what, let's roll with that. Like, every time we die, just change another letter in her name. And see what we end up with by the end. It's like, we'll get to the point where you've changed every letter in the name, and then you need to start changing letters again. You can rearrange the letters. You're a braver man than I am. I am terrible at anagrams. Yeah, there it goes. Garbage grenades. The size of the explosion on the grenades, though, is absurd. I don't think I've ever seen grenades have such large explosions in video games. Yeah, it is a good question. I mean, it's fairly uncommon for, as far as I'm aware, for actors to play games that they're in, like voice actors or anything. It's like, there was a thing a few months ago of the voice actor for Claire in Resident Evil 2 Remake started playing Resident Evil 2 Remake on Twitch, and it was kind of interesting. It's like this case of, in Metal Gear Solid, the only actor in Metal Gear Solid, the only voice actor in Metal Gear Solid who's actually played all the games they've been in is David Hayter. How long does this go for? Jeez. It's doing you in. Are we almost done with this sequence? Like, how big are the sewers in a virtual world where, like, let's face it, there doesn't need to be sewers in this world. You think if you were gonna create anything, any kind of virtual world for this kind of thing, you'd remove the need, like any of the need for humans to poop in the virtual reality. That's death. Yep. Oh yeah, no, the anecdote for that, because if you check, Soul Reaver 2 has a bunch of outtakes, and one of the outtakes it shows is him talking to Simon Templeman, the actor who played Kane, about trying to play Soul Reaver, and it's amazing. And Simon Templeman is just there, like, yep. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, yeah. It's fantastic. Keeps falling off the rock. I look up, 3 hours have passed. He leaves the room to go and get a drink or something, comes back, and his daughter's immediately way beyond that. It's like, props to Michael Bell for trying, though. I actually did see, not that long ago, one of those Q&A sections you get at conventions, a video of it on YouTube, and Michael Bell is talking about the sequence there. It makes me wonder how many times he's told the story in recorded form. Well, that's really cool. I love the outtakes that are in both Soul Reaver 2 and Defiance. Like, they're great. Yeah, there's definitely, it's a convention Q&A, and it's very clearly years later. Okay, this music is actually just coming really loudly for some reason. And I don't know why. Like, where was this music, like, 20 minutes ago? And there it goes. You're gonna have that blaring sewer music for your exciting sewer fights. Oh god, we're back to that one freaking loop. So that level was called Malachi and Bane, and we didn't find Malachi or Bane. Oh, okay. That's clear. Oh, come on, you remember Bane from The Matrix, don't you, Clem? I feel like our Bane chose way too common a name. It's like, it doesn't come up at all. And then it's gonna come up like 7 different streams in a row.
Malachi, I'll cover you.
Well, you say he betrays everybody. He gets possessed by Smith. Oh God, Ballard is back. I cannot aim like this. Look at his face. I think you might be a bit judgmental there, Clint. Is it because of the goatee? God, Ballard is dying again. God damn it. Like, who would have thought Ballard would turn up again and then die again? Everybody wears sunglasses in The Matrix, though. It's dark as shit in the sewers, and they're all wearing sunglasses. You know what the funny thing is with that, though? Like, after Ballard gets possessed, not after Bane gets possessed by Smith, he never wears sunglasses again. Because Bane doesn't go back into the Matrix after that.
Cover
you. Let's go. Okay, let me try this.
Malachi.
Ballard is both a bullet magnet and terrible at actually shooting back. Oh, thank God. This guy poop his pants in public. Ah, crap. Will we? What if the agent just decided, you know what? No, you won't draw me away. I'm gonna go after them.
I am the Keymaker, and you are not meant to die here. You must hurry.
Talk about Deus Ex Machina. Ugh. Of all the things, just like, yeah, no, make you shit your pants. Django already smiled.
Where'd they go?
Where are we?
The Matrix is structured like a building. It rests atop a foundation that is built upon a substructure. We're standing in a programmer's maintenance passage. It is how I escaped.
Escaped?
I have been held captive in a chateau in the mountains by an exile named the Merovingian. He imprisoned me for my keys.
You will find I lack the virtues of both tolerance and patience.
Au travail.
But even he cannot keep me from playing my part in what will come. My purpose I have seen is entwined with your own.
What purpose?
It's a very special.
Yeah, I was thinking that.
Meant only for the
war.
Will you bring it to it?
And then flashback to the MTV Movie Awards skit future. Where Will Ferrell played the architect.
Everyone moves. And their brains are Jackson Pollock.
Drop it.
So these two characters get a very brief appearance in The Matrix Reloaded.
You didn't think we left that door.
Where Monica Bellucci walks into a room and then shoots the guy on the right in the head.
I think he did. Look at his face. That's just like a human. This mustn't happen.
It already has.
You must stop them. They'll ruin everything.
Was there a point to any of that?
The key is integral to the path of the one.
Why don't you just make another one?
Once it is used, it cannot be used again. They will bring about the end of everything.
I think that the one on the right is supposed to be a werewolf. And that's the whole thing Monica Bellucci does. Like, how many people do you know that carry silver bullets in their guns and then shoots them in the head?
No reception.
We need to get that key. See if you can call Sparks from the roof.
So this is another point where they split and go in different directions. And it actually does affect the game. Depending on the story, yeah. Well, Blade just wanted to do its own thing for the most part. Ah, there's a lot more modelled back here than you would have expected. Hmm. Okay. Yeah, you remember the twins? Remember how heavily featured the twins were in the advertising for The Matrix Reloaded? So, this doesn't happen with Ghost. You go a completely different way and go to the roof with Ghost. And you don't go to the attic. But I think we're actually going to call it here because it is almost 1 o'clock. I've been streaming for 5 hours now. I can do with another drink. My throat is getting pretty dry. And I could do with just moving around a little bit. Yeah, it's been kind of interesting to go back to the enter the Matrix. It's been years since I've played this this far. Well, you caught most of the stream, didn't you, Ninja? Weren't you here at the start? Am I thinking of somebody else? Was I not paying attention to who was actually here? You were not. Who the hell am I thinking of then? Well, I'm glad you got to catch some of the stream as well, Ninja. Thanks for hanging out. Let me just check this. No, I thought you were here. I thought you'd already been here. Was the main thing, Ninja. Let me see. That's all well and good. Check. All right. Nah, I don't forget. Oh, no, okay, you guys. I thought you'd been here was the thing, Ninja. I'm getting shit mixed up. I'm sorry about it, man. But like, thanks for joining the stream, guys. Thanks for hanging around. We'll be back tomorrow at the usual time, 8 p.m. GMT. Greenwich Mean Time with Wind Waker HD. We're going to go through what we did today again, just on HD. If anybody wants to join the Discord is there. Come join us on the Discord. We say stuff sometimes. And you get all the announcements about the stream and the YouTube channel, and sometimes I remember I post funny pictures there. But in the meantime, I want to thank everybody who joined the stream. Thank you so much for watching. I always really appreciate the support. Big special thank you to everybody in the chat. That is Bane, Klim, Ninja, Teak, Star, Offworld Devil. Was there anybody else? I think that's it. If I've forgotten anybody, then big special thank you to you too. Once again, back tomorrow, 8 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time with Wind Waker HD. We're going to redo everything we did today, just on the HD version. Enter the Matrix will return. So I'm probably going to do this again, finish this up. Probably Sunday. Because on Saturday we are doing more Devil May Cry 3. But Sunday we'll be back with more Enter the Matrix. I'll have to try and remember the schedule at this point. Wind Waker HD tomorrow. Devil May Cry 3 Saturday. Oh, the bot was about to put the Discord link, that's fine. And Enter the Matrix Sunday. Enter the Matrix will return when I can be bothered. It's probably Sunday. I feel like we're over halfway through the game now. We got the chateau, and then there's the power plant, and then there's the Smith chase, I think. And I think that's it. It's just that the chateau and the power plant take a while. But I think we should be able to finish this next time. But that is it for today. Once again, big special thank you to everybody who joined the chat. Thank you so much to everybody who's watching. Always really appreciate the support and everybody keeping me company. It's cool stuff. You guys are all cool dudes. But in the meantime, thank you all for watching. Have yourselves a fantastic time of day. And take care. Catch you next time. You too, Ninja. You too, Ninja. See you later, guys.